Hey guys, it's Genesis Probe and welcome back to another video. Today I'm going to be playing some Tera, except I'm going to be playing it normal. So we're going to go in here. I'm going to keep my second monitor, have everything that I need on it at this moment. Let's open this. And, oh, Tera crashed. Wait for the program to respond. There we go. And I think I'm going to play... I'm definitely not going to play Gunner or Brawler. I play those classes way too much, but they're just... Oh, they're great. I love these classes so much. Brawler is so much fun. I have actually on my stream... You know what? I think I'm actually going to play Brawler. Because, oh, I love Brawler so much. We're going to play Brawler. So while I'm customizing, I want to talk a little bit about this. So, one thing is that... hold on. I got to pick a hairstyle. Stick with that one, I guess. I'm actually gonna try and probably make this look a lot like my original character. Let's go with that one. So pretty much this is just gonna be, oh my god, those eyeballs. I need to fix that. So pretty much what I'm going to be doing is, this is pretty much just a little bit more of an in-depth series that I'm gonna be doing solo, rather than what I was doing beforehand. So let's, yeah. I just need to fix the eyes. Shrink them, or no, keep them up, make them a little bit. She looks so freaking cross-eyed. Okay, I need to go back to face and I need different eyes. So yeah, this is pretty much just gonna be me, holy crap, going solo through all the achievements, getting just again a little bit more stuff for you guys, because I don't know, I'm really into Tera right now. Actually, I'm not gonna change any of this. I'm gonna go straight to eyes and a little bit closer together. Make them a little bit smaller, that's fine. Nose is okay. Mouth, I have like a specific mouth that I like. I don't like super thick lips, tight with a little bit of a pucker. And then raise them a little bit. She doesn't look as upset. She just looks like she's clenching her lips. No. There we go. Ears are fine. Outfit, not gonna change it. Yeah, that'll be fine. Let's go with the same name I'm using. Oh, it's Taken. Let's do that one. That's definitely not Taken. So yeah, pretty much just gonna be playing this by myself. It's gonna be a solo adventure of Tera. I'm also gonna be going for as many achievements as possible, as always. Because, I don't know, that's just how I've been playing it. Ever since I started doing that, I've just been playing. Here, I'll let this cutscene run.
Wars of the gods and titans, destroying the world it was. Amid the tragedy, a single drop of hope coalesced to preserve one tiny part. Sheltered from time, a mystical tree grew, giving fresh eyes the power to see the world as the gods once saw it. The world's greatest scholars and magicians came to study the divine tree and protect it. They magically erased the island from mortal records, but not before the forces of evil sent their own champion.
So, anyway, this is probably the safest class for me to play with because it's the one I have the most experience with, and the counter mechanics. So pretty much left hit, you got four swing types, And then if you counter after each swing type, you get different types of attack. So if you do after the first one, you get a stronger attack. If you do after two, you get a knockup. If you do after three, you get my favorite attack, which is an AoE spin that draws enemies into you. And then for finisher, if you do four, one, two, and then counter, bam, super hit. And then you can press C to dash. Pretty much that's it in a nutshell. So we're going to pick up this first quest, which is Anya speaks highly of us. We got a volunteer. We need Sorrow Tree Bark. So what we need to do is run over here. As you can see on the side here, we have our quest tracker. For anyone who hasn't played Tera, this is straightforward. A couple things I've shifted. This normally sits up here. And I think everything else is pretty much... I think for my friend, this bar is normally on top. I like it on the bottom right above the experience. Pretty much as low as it can go. Anyway, and then you can press escape to bring up the cursor. And then press F to examine and interact with. So now we have this. We can go back and talk to Glenok. And as I showed before, we get our first achievement, First Steps in the Larger World, which I think, if you press V, you can go to your achievements. That is a Tours of Duty, just for completing the first quest. As you can see here, though, we are going to be going for Champion, which is just 95% of all achievements completed. I believe that number is, I have it right here, minus that. Here, let me actually pull up my calculator very quickly. So it's going to be 24th. Okay, so the amount that I'm going for in my series with my friend Steven is 24,345 points, but that includes special. So I subtract all the special achievements, that's 13,465, and if we times that by 95, I need to score 12,792 points, which means there are achievements that I can avoid. But anyway, we're gonna start this next one to soothe the crying child. So Anya's in, like, crying. She's upset. So we need to go talk to her and figure out what's going on. I'm not gonna do this all the time. A lot of times I'm gonna skip through this so she can't find Zozo. And then he wanted to play with it. Peter and Jared and took him. I'm not gonna be doing this all the time because I normally go as quickly through stuff as I can. Oh, search the bushes. I try to skip through it as much as possible. Okay, now I gotta check on Zozo. Zozo's not in good condition, so we got Zozo. Here, we need to fix him. Oh, sorry, fix him. Don't tell Anya. He gives us needle and thread, and then we need to pick up three pieces of sticky grass. Anyway, I've been having a lot of fun with Tera, which is why I've been making so much content. Anyway, back to this. You can press I to enter your inventory window, and you can right-click on some items like this, and then it will combine them. So now we have a patch Zozo, which now we can go talk to Anya about. But, I don't know. I've been having a lot of fun with this. And so here's Zozo. Sit right next to Zozo, so we need to play with Zozo and enter the instance. But yeah, so Tera's been a lot of fun for me. I thought I'd take some time... make an actual series, because I know a lot of people do, and this is also a more in-depth way for me to go about talking about achievements rather than doing the 2-hour long summaries. It also shows my personal play style for how I play the game, so I think it's good all around. And it's also some stat padding. I play games too much. It's some video padding in case something goes wrong and I don't put a video out. These are going to go up, or like, let's say I'm in between recording real series, like right now, Last of Us should be running. At least when I'm recording this, Last of Us is running. I'm recording this on the 26th of January. So, oh, better plug in my laptop, it's about to die. I'm recording this on the 26th of January. Anyway, so we can complete this quest. Anya's going to run off. We get an always about fighting, which I believe is also... for completing this quest. And then we talk to Anya. Here, I'll talk a little bit more once we get into combat. It got dark, Tiara doesn't feel good. We gotta kill the Gileados after we talk to Anya. They're mean, steal sap, stop them. So we gotta kill three of them. So, The Last of Us is probably done at the time of this, and I'm trying to get the first bit, because I have the next couple in mind of what I want to play. Tera is going to be the main thing on the channel, though, and these are going to be little separate series, but the Tera ones take a long time to put together. Anyway, so one, two, three, and spin. Favorite combo. Or do two, and then just keep them disabled. Anyway, sorry if you hear me clicking a lot. Just how I play. I don't like the Paverns. I never pick those up. You ain't gonna do anything, bro. Oh, that also has knockback on it, so... Did you drop anything? Ooh, you dropped some Sun Essence. I'll take that. Now you're dead. That's three Gileadus. Anyway, so yeah, Last of Us is probably done. And so this is going to be going up in between the time between these two series, and then this will be going up in tandem with whatever's next. The problem is the next one I wanted to do, I need to do this prequel to it, because you won't understand a lot of the context. So I'm trying to work on getting the prequel. The prequel's really long. So it'll take me a while to get it, and what I try to do is I try to get most of the content, or like half of it, before I start putting them up, so I at least have something in case something goes wrong. But anyway, here, let's complete this quest with Emin. Three of the Gileadus, thanks. And here, let's accept the next quest first, which is here after all this vanishes. So there's a Prime Gileadu, his name, or we can identify him, talk to Anya back in the village after it's safe. So here we're going to pick up a Roundhouse Kick, which is our first spell. Where it kicks monsters into the air, increasing rage. We don't have rage, but that's this bar here. We'll get into that later once we get our first ability, which happens at level 10, I believe. Anyway, so what we can do is we can run up, and using this, it knocks enemies into the air in an arc around us. Or at least, God, I don't know why I say us, because I'm the one playing here. Okay, Varkas is dead, which kills all the rest of the Gileadus. You could go farm them for a little bit, but I don't like doing that. Anyway, we're just going to run this way, make some progress. So yeah, because it takes so long to record for that series and get at least a good chunk of this stuff together, this is going to go up in the meantime. So that way something's still going up every other day, which I'm trying to keep to as much as possible. I have missed a couple days, but that was due to other issues. Regardless, I'm trying to create a schedule, make a thriving YouTube channel. You know, the basics. Anyway, gotta pick up some stinking mud on the way over, because it smells and it's not good. So now we need to go talk to Emin. I think we can look at it. What does it say? Foul-smelling dirt with even fouler-smelling seeds in it. So, growing Gileadus, I guess? Probably. Also, for collecting things, you do get experience. But maybe not for this stuff. Anyway. Killed the prime Gileadu. Yeah, they're Gileadu seeds. They'll take the last ones down. Well, these seeds won't be able to take root. So we hit level 3 now. We got a new weapon, the Fist of Solitude. We'll put that together in a minute. So now we need to go talk to Anya and Glenek. Anyway, let's equip this so we get what? One more attack modifier and one more impact. And then we counter up to 68 more damage. Pretty okay. Nice thing is counter, I believe, is no cost. Yeah, it has no cost, whereas counter costs 100 MP, and this replenishes MP. I believe it's 1% or 2%. If you press L, you can check your quest. If you press K, you can check your skills. It doesn't say how much MP it replenishes. That might be a passive. No. Well, one thing I do want to talk about, though, is Deadly Fury. This is probably the greatest spell or greatest passive, because if you die from monsters, not from other characters, you consume all your rage to recover 50% of your maximum HP once every 5 minutes. If you're smart, or like you're really careful, this doesn't trigger very often, and when it does trigger, it can help you win a fight really easily, but the problem is you need to rebuild your rage, which is central to the brawlers, and we'll go over that a little bit later, but for now, let's just try and get off Tutorial Island. I don't think we'll do it this episode, because I'm spending time looking at all this stuff. So, hi, explain today's experiment, pour some water on the sapling. I think for the most part, I'm not really going to talk about the story. Anyway, we need to talk to Glenek again while they chant to boost the tree, so... never happened before, the lights, the sap, run like that, Anya might be right, you're something special. Do a test, need some TR and sap from the storehouse, take Anya. So once this grows a little bit, then we can talk, because we can't talk to her right now. She's in the middle of a scripted event. Now we can talk to her. So now we need to go. So we need to follow her to the storehouse. If you you can follow her, but you can look on the map here. The storehouse is right over here. So this is the storehouse right here. And while if you press escape, you can still hold down W and keep moving. But if you click another button, It's like, here, I'll holding W. If I let go and then I press it again, it just brings me back. So some stuff to keep in mind. You only have a minute to do this, so if a minute passes, it'll reset. Most of these events where it's timed like that, where you have to follow or escort or whatever, it's not really... it's not strict. You're pretty much free to do whatever you want. Or not whatever you want, but you have a lot of extra time, so something not to worry about. What? Hold on, I'm trying to press escape. I want my cursor, please. I just realized that this page didn't load for me. What happened to this web page? Did it get taken down? It's closed. Oh no. Oh, that's not good. I needed that. Hold on. Just search it. Oh my god, no results. They shut down the old forums. Oh no. Oh my god. I can't believe they reset. They just, oh, that's not helpful. That means, oh, I didn't take the video. Anyway, so she's scared. Rumble, what's that rumbling? Really bad habit, we need to get out of here. So then 7 Argon Thralls are gonna spawn. They won't aggro you, so you can walk away and do whatever you want. I didn't level up. If I killed a couple more Gileadus, I'd be level 4. What we wanna do is we wanna run into here, especially as a brawler. So much free damage, I love it. Once you kill one of them, you will level up. There we go, we're done. So let's check our skills. You get Jackhammer. This is almost, I guess, the bread and butter. You attack with a flurry of jabs, increasing your rage and decreasing your enemy's endurance by 1% per hit. I'm not 100% sure what endurance does. I think it's like, if we press P, we can check stats. Stats, endurance. Class-based stat effect. Okay, this is your defense. An impact factor affects your impact. Balance factor is your getting knocked down. This is how much you need to, I guess, to knock down an enemy. Power is just your attack, movement speed, flight speed, 0. We're not flying. And here are all your combat stats. Crit factor is 50%, which means if we crit, we do 50% bonus damage. No, 50% chance to crit. And crit power is double. Sorry, crit resist. Is you resist crits, attacks 259, pretty much all that stuff. Then resistances to each individual stat type. Gathering 0 instances, we haven't gotten to any instances. Reputation, none. Dungeons, none. Costuming, none. Anyway, Anya will follow us as we start to leave. And then we have 4 Argon foot soldiers. So what you want to do here is what I do is I wail on this guy 4 times. Counter, knock up, jackhammer. So as you can see, jackhammer is really helpful. It's actually better as not as a finisher. So let's do... like that. It does a lot of damage. I use it as a finisher because it's really easy to do that. One of the nice things is it actually keeps a target CC'd, which is crowd control. Means that it can't do anything, so this knockup pretty much means that he can't do anything, so knockup, and then he stays in the air, if not flies higher. So it's a really easy way to deal with a single enemy or a group of them if you hit them with roundhouse kick. So under attacks, the Argons, it's bad, gotta kill the Argons. I won't make it, I'll let you help me. So we can't jump through the barrier yet, even though it was gone. So we need to kill 2 Argon sentries and 2 Argon strikers. This is pretty easy. Look at that, dead. But in any sort of scenario where you have a lot of enemies that are fighting at once, you generally want to use the 3-hit counter. It's so useful. And it actually does a lot of damage. But if you're focusing a single target, doing the knockup is the way to go. Because it's just... again, it's CC. It's CC is always helpful. And this guy's dead. So now they're all dead. After we kill 2 of each of them, every single other enemy here dies. And then we need to talk to Emin. Something important. That's all of them we need to check. Did you see Jalka? Did you find Anya? Children are the priority. We head this way. Yeah, we can press right-click to counter. We have the Argon Predator spawn over here. I think I can actually run past him. I think I'm past him. Oh, yeah, I am. Haha. So here, it's teaching you that you can counter. So when he attacks you, you get two different types of counters. There's defense, and then there's perfect defense. And perfect defense means that you counter within a short enough window that you actually deal damage to your opponent. So here, will you attack again? There's perfect defense. So he took 11 damage for that counter. And then because I was in the middle of countering... So once he gets below 80% health, he starts walking away. Let's see if I can do it again. I actually did this in my series, but if you run far enough this way, you actually won't get pulled into the Argon Spike. Hey, buddy. And then, of course, he instantly dies. So here, technically, he killed me, even though I wasn't over there. And then we fall unconscious. These are probably going to be longer, like 30 or 40 minutes each, because it's really hard to get a lot of content in a short amount of time. So, anyway, we wake up, we're here at Chadtree, we're outside of all the instances, so now there's a bunch of other people around. Anyway, let's talk to Walgray. You survived. Can't tell you were relieved. Thing appeared, everyone took cover, only one standing ground. You're the only one who saw him. The Argons left. They were looking for something or someone. Anya's safe. She's stayed in the storehouse. Some of the other gifted children aren't accounted for. So we level up. We get the Hauberka Family Ties, which is just a better defensive tool. So I'm going to equip that. And so Federation soldiers from the post on Windmill Hill have arrived to help. We can trust them. Taking good care of us. Have Emin introduce us to Dogal. Dogal's going to be pretty central from here on out. So there's Dogal. Hey, Dogal. What's up, bro? Talk to Emin. Glad to see you're okay. Feared the worst, we found you. This is Dogal. It's arranged to bring emergency supplies. You're free to stay and help with cleanup. Your talents will be wasted shifting debris. Go, Dogal. Follow his orders. Talk to Anya. She was worried about you. She's looking for the other children. Made our plans for the assault, so you've got a little time. Oh, I just go Napranya. I don't talk to Dogal. I don't have a horse yet. By the way, one thing I should mention is that each class has a special ability, and then each race has a special ability. For the fighter class, you get this ability, Deft Footwork, which has an hour cooldown time, but it prevents the chance of knockdown by 50% for 3 minutes while in PvP combat. So... something nice to know. Look, Zozo, Sazriel's back. Are you okay? Jalka says thank you. No, I know he was there. I'm afraid to go inside. Something bad will happen. Let's talk to Churik. I'm actually going to skip a lot of this because I want to try and get off the island soon. And there's still a little bit to do. We get off the island at level 10. So Finless is dead. So I guess he was one of the kids. He's dead now. And we gotta run this way. Then here's Rykan with Sharla's lifeless body. She was so worried. She's dead. So now we gotta wait for Anya to run up here. She stopped right up there, clearly, because that guy stopped and leveled up. Means I'm gonna level up too. So now we need to follow her further up the tree, but we have a new skill. Let's learn. We have Pile Driver, which delivers a series of uppercuts while leaping into the air, then end with a powerful downward blow. And then we can upgrade punch to level 2 and counter to level 2. That just means counter does more damage. That's about it. So now we run up here to Anya. I keep calling her Anna. And she's going to run over to here, I think, like right here. Oh, way farther ahead. Something's wrong. Kill the blue monsters. Gotta kill 3 suffering bears and an Argon infected bear. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna run over here. So here's Pile Driver, by the way. That last hit is an AoE,
pretty much the whole thing is AoE. So that's two suffering bears. Let's take some HP back. Some gold. Let's go find one more. So a really good combo is to knock into the air with roundhouse kick. Oh, did I hit you? Oh, I did hit you. So there was a perfect defense. Again. There we go, level 7. Now let's kill one Argon infected bear. Another thing is that you can counter into a knockup. And then, of course, what I just did, jackhammer into pile driver, and then I would have done a roundhouse kick had he not already almost been dead. Anyway, run up here. Anya's waiting up here with Payson. Also pretty important later. So pretty much, Anya's gonna run ahead, and Payson wants us to trigger on the Argon detectors so it could prevent further bears from turning. Makes this sound like it's a vampire thing. So that's done. That's two. Then redo this one, because lasts for a very short time. Talk to Payson. Then maybe in the village, go check. Of course, I'm skimming, so I don't actually know for sure what it says. I don't know exactly the words of these, but got the general idea. I have played to level 65, and they recently added another dungeon. So, now we get a lot of stuff. And we get more skills. We get Haymaker. This is also a pretty good skill. It's good as a finisher. So you look at Haymaker, you wind up and you throw a big punch with a high chance of knocking an enemy down, and the skill increases your rage a lot. And it's an execute spell. It executes, which means the lower your enemy's health is, the more damage it does. That's Haymaker. So what we're going to do is we're actually going to change all of our gear, because we just got this new attack weapon, which does a lot more damage, higher modifier, and much more counter. Then we have a new shirt, new gauntlets, new shoes. What we can do also is we can come over here to the merchant and sell all these. You can right-click to instantly move it into the other thing. I'm going to sell all those for some free cash. And we might be able to actually finish the island. We have to go through here to there, and then we have an instance to do, and then we're done. So I think we're going to finish the island in this episode, and we'll be right about to leave when I finish. I'm so stupid. I need to go back. We need to read Emmon's note. When we do, we have to talk to Dogal, but saying Anya's nowhere to be found. She insisted on leaving, other children are in danger, have all the guardians gathered, and we are escorting her to Tiara, and follow us without delay. So Emmon's further ahead, but now we need to talk to Dogal again, and he pretty much says, go with them. I can actually check the text. If you press L, then you click on a mission. Why didn't Emmon tell me they were going up the tree? We're this close to launching our assault, escorted the girl and rescued the children, finished off the Argons, we call the troops back, assemble the proper attack, we'll be ready within the hour. So we need to get rid of these Argons. These Argon Kelba drones. And one Overseer. So you need to kill one little group and you're done. Also, one thing to note. Any of these enemies that have the green, as you see on the map here, this light green, they won't attack you if you walk close to them. Like, they're just leaving me alone. They're not actually attacking me. See, they're not actually... they're kind of ignoring. Like, they get the little exclamation mark, meaning they note there's my presence. But they're not actually going to attack me. They just back off and prep to attack. But as long as I don't attack them, they won't attack me. If the enemies are red, if you get too close, they will attack you. So you need to keep that in mind. So here we see some Valkyrian Federation soldiers here. Talk to Bertel. Shouldn't be here, too dangerous. Pretty much Anya went this way. No offense, we're all seasoned soldiers and you're a novice brawler, or whatever your class is. What makes you think you can get through? You're no responsible. Keep going. Anyway, we just got two signet rings. We didn't have any rings on, so we can equip both of these, because you can equip two rings, and you can equip, if we press P, we can check. We can equip two rings, two earrings, a necklace, a brooch, innerwear, which we don't have, a belt, and then a mask, a helmet, and then, of course, the weapon, shoes, gauntlets, and jacket. Here we get a little cutscene. It's just going to show pretty much the Argons are here. But I'll be quiet in case there's any volume. I don't think there is, though. So the Argons are attacking the tree. So we gotta kill three Argon soldiers. So one thing I wanna show here is here's an Argon soldier. I'm gonna hit him straight up with Haymaker. 668 damage. That's a lot of damage. It's pretty nice. It also does have a long cooldown. But, so 668 damage. So there's this dude. Let's wail on this dude. Get him really low. 2, 3. So he's at 4%. 2,000, but that was also a crit. So if it didn't crit, it would have done 1,300 damage. As you can see, it does significantly more damage the lower the enemy's HP is. I think it does 1% per 1% missing health. Something like that. 1% bonus damage. So anyway, we need to talk to Lassiter, I think is his name. So we need to run off this way to the tree, which we saw is being leeched on by the Argons. There's the ship. And then when we get over here, we're looking for Deplid, but there's too many Argons. So we need to kill three Argon shock troopers. 1, 2, knock up, jackhammer, pile driver. Into Roundhouse here. So I've played a lot of Brawler, and I mean a lot of Brawler. Brawler is probably my most played class. And then second played is Gunner, because I have another level 65 Gunner, and then, of course, on my regular account, or on the account I'm using with my partner for the series, I'm playing another Gunner. So I have a lot of experience. Anyway. Let's go over here. We find Deplin. I'm going to enter my inventory. I'm going to talk to him. Now we need to... You can't see it here, but we need to launch the flare. Use the flare gun to call the soldier to rescue Deplin. So we talk to Deplin. And then... Now we're level 10. We get an achievement for that. Going to learn Rampage. This is our first Rage skill, which instantly gives us 3,000 range. Rage. At 3,000 Rage, we run at an enemy, and we hit them a lot of times in a row. I think it's, what, like 15 hits or something? Rush enemies 20 meters away and deliver a series of devastating blows. Knocks monsters into the air. Does not affect players and blocks attack. And you get defenses if they attack you from the front. Correct timing gets a perfect defense which deals one critical hit to the enemy and generates an additional 200 rage. So pretty much you want to use that if there's a huge attack coming in and you want to still keep your damage output high. On a lot of the endgame bosses, I'll show that's what you're supposed to do. But for now, we have to run up here and we have to enter the gate here that's kind of broken. It says open the gate, but it's kind of broken. This is actually a teleporter. So now we go into an instance, and after this we will be done. This shouldn't take too terribly long, but I'm not 100% sure. By the way, the reason I spent Rampage is that anytime you go through a teleporter, it instantly starts depleting your rage, and I think it's at 300 per second. So, and also if you don't attack anything for 30 seconds, you'll deplete your rage. So here's Zozo, and Anya would never do it, leave him, and he's still warm. And here's another cutscene.
Children should be seen and never heard. Nothing can stop me now.
Assuming you've played the game, you know who that is, and we'll actually meet him sometime soon. Here's Emin lying on the ground, got separated, pretty much got beat. You need to look for Anya further up in the temple of the tree. But upon entering here, ambush! You need to defeat. So, yeah, so Argon energy crackles. So we got caught in an ambush. So now we just need to kill all six of these. I'm actually going to pick this up because it's an uncommon item. We get the uncommon ground achievement. Anyway, dead. Oh man, I love this class. Especially when you start getting some of the, when you get the skill glyphs. Oh my god, I've gotten some amazing combos. It's so nice. And later on, all of our attacks will crit. And I think one point, I think on my Brawler, I have something like crit factor. I have no idea. I think my crit factor is like, five times or something. Let's just do that. So now Rampage is available. Now that we have the Argon Rake coming, which is like a little boss, I'm actually going to hit him with Rampage because I can. So he's going to run to the middle of the room. When he stops, I'm going to now sail on him and just do most of his health bar in damage. And goodbye. The counter killed him. Counter does do damage, just this attack does damage. So keep that in mind. What can I tell you? You can use that for kills if you're playing smart, but pretty much Anya needs us, so let's go. Also, here I'm actually going to try to escape the Argon Predator, because I failed to do it during the series, but we will see what happens. By the way, this whole part took like an hour and a half when playing with my partner. We're already almost done with it, and it's what? Here, can you jump towards me, please? Thank you. I want you to come this way. I want you to come closer to the wall. If you hold on the right button, by the way, you'll keep countering. I don't know if that actually, like, defends against more or not. Are you gonna jump? Come on. Thank you. Oh, yeah, that doesn't counter yet. I don't have the skill glyph to counter. There is a skill glyph where after you cast Roundhouse Kick, if you cast any other of your main spells, it counts as a defense. I got double perfect defense in that. I think he's gonna freak out now. Yeah, there we go. So I'm gonna run over here into the flowers. Actually, this may still be too close. I don't think I'm gonna get far enough away. Yeah, no, I didn't get far enough away. Gosh, dang it.
That's unfortunate. I think I get like 5 seconds of protection from Anya. Where is it? I don't see it on my buff bar. There it is. So now we're instantly gonna just rampage because we have bonus damage. Like, look how much more damage we're doing now. Oh, I didn't block that. We also have increased attack speed. Let's just do another rampage. And then, goodbye, buddy. 417, jeez. I didn't do any bonus damage. Anyway, I saw it first as I think for collecting 10 items. Anyway, we can go into our inventory. These Wonder Rings are exactly identical in stats to the Alien Signet Rings, so you can equip them if you want to, but we get earrings and necklace too, so we get some nice stuff. And there she is. I got lost for a second. Anyway, talk to Anya. Unfortunately, upon trying to remove her, everything freaks out. I don't know why that cutscene is necessary. It's pretty much just us going, no! Oops. But pretty much upon trying to move on, you know, the tree starts freaking out. So we need to talk to Dogal. And now we get teleported out. And it's funny because if you teleport out, the ground still shakes. Because what it's doing is it shakes your camera. It doesn't actually shake the world, it just shakes the camera. Anyway, so we complete that quest. We level up to 11. My bad, I thought it was 10. And then we can equip all new gear. We get a better weapon, a better shirt, a better gauntlet, and better greaves. So that's our style right now. We've reached level 11, we got to stop a predator. Another achievement. So let's just drop all this stuff in here, sell it, and drop these on the ground, and sell, and ta-da! We are rolling in cash! 88 silver worth of cash. These we'll get into later, all of this stuff. Pretty much all these other menus we'll get into later. But, so, pretty much having some fun with the first episode. We got 6 achievements. Woo! Not too shabby. We're up to 60 points. Each one is 10, because they're really easy. I'm pretty sure I saw it first as a, extracurricular achievement. Yeah, looted 10 items. Okay. By the way, just noting now, these 6 achievements I probably will not receive. Or I may get You Picked Me in Party Maker. The rest I probably won't, because I'm not going to actively be going for those items. I'm probably going to be spending most of the time solo, because brawlers can do that. Brawlers are really good at that, especially once you know what you're doing. Anyway, also, one of the last achievements I'm going to get the last couple are probably going to be Speed Demon. And it's down here somewhere. I'm also probably not going to pick up these. Anyway, Speed Demon. And... oh, these are all really easy. And uncommon valor. In rare form. This is necessary for a lot of achievements, but it's very hard to get because you can loot items later on and you can get like 4 items from it, but it'll count as one looted rare item because it only happened once. So this achievement is very hard to get and you spend a lot of time, and I think there's only like one way to do it. As far as I'm aware, I don't know if you can actually grind out items and get it that way, but anyway, that's it for this episode of Tera. Let's zoom in on my character. No, it's not. She's creepy. Check this. I think it's just login reward. Yeah. So for every day when you log in, you get 5 Federation bills. And I accept. I'm going to delete this. You can see what time it is. Actually, this clock is completely wrong. So, oh, well. Delete that. Anyway, so in this episode, we pretty much completed the tutorial area. We need to go talk to... we need to do this last quest, and then we head off the island. And then we head over to the main city of Velika on the first continent. So next time on Tera, we'll be doing just that. See you guys then.